offense, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's an element of ownership going on.
We are doing Back for Good by Take That. Whatever I said, whatever I did, I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good. Want you back, want you back, want you back for good. Whenever I'm wrong, just tell me the song and I'll sing it. Take that.
Take that.
We should say that this was
a
request.
My God, take that.
Who requested it? Are we going to keep up our tradition of like, this is a request by
you know who you are.
Kylie.
Blame Schlane.
Kylie.
Blame Schlane.
I won't name and shame, but I'll just say Kylie requested it.
Kylie.
Yeah.
Old Kylie Minogue. She's always on our case.
Yeah, she's just like, I'm going to take that fucking Robbie Williams down for good. He didn't fuck me in the kids video.
Yeah. He's still got my gold shorts and I want them back for good.
All right, let's get into the lyrics here. The first verse. I guess now it's time for me to give up. I feel it's time. What? Okay. Got a picture of you beside me. Got your lipstick mark still on your coffee cup. Got a fist of pure emotion. Got a head of shattered dreams. Got to leave it. Got to leave it all behind now.
Yeah. I think if you're trying to mend your relationship, maybe don't go in with a fist of anything, really.
Proper sleeves, your fist out of it, champion.
It's never going to work out well when you enter it with a fist. Like,
I reckon a fist of pure emotion is a really obscure way of describing a Muppet.
He takes out his rage on a Muppet.
Like, this is my friend Kermit the Frog, or as I like to call him, fist of pure emotion.
My heart is hurting.
Do you think he's like facing like battery charges here? He's like in court. They're like, mate, you do not hit a woman. It's like, look.
I didn't hit. It was a fist of pure emotion.
Yeah, it was more emotional, an emotional hit rather than...
Look at it. It's red. It's crying.
The thing is, it says, like, the first two lines that I guess now it's time for me to give up. I feel it's time. It's like he's really doubled down on the that what time it is.
He's like, I want to cook. I think I'll cook. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. Cooking it is for me.
Back on that.
Sounds like to me.
Just back on that. Back on that fist of pure emotion in the defense in the court. It's like,
We'll just go up the lyrics then, shall we, Ryan?
Well, no, we were talking about it before. It's important.
Like, what's the defense in court?
We wait too long and it's going to be not funny.
I want to know what this is.
I'm trying to stall him here. I don't want to hear what he's about to say.
Suspect's head was bashed in. No, she had a head of shattered dreams.
No, her head was fucking like that.
Oh, good one.
Her head is like shattered. It's like they're her dreams.
Yeah.
Blunt, severe battery. No, head of shattered dreams.
Yeah.
Well, what kind of... what kind of psychopath doesn't wash dishes to preserve a lipstick mark that's been left there from yesteryear, from a loved one? Like, you must have a photo of her or something like that that you can cherish and hold on to, but instead he's like, no, don't wash that cup. Why not? See that? Lipstick mark.
Yeah, still there.
Who's that from? That's from my ex-girlfriend.
Yeah, 9 years ago.
Mate. Why have you still got it? Well, I want it back. For good. Yeah, I feel it's time.
You see this fist?
This is really... The world really needs you to wash your hands right now. Like, there's a global pandemic. What did you just say?
Yeah. I'll wash my hands, but I will never wash this cup.
Yeah, that is true. It's kind of got a real... You expect to, like... They're like, oh, you can just put your coat in the closet over there and you go and open it up and there's just candles lit and a shrine of photos and a coffee cup with a lipstick mark on it in there. Yeah. It's actually pretty dark to be sung to such a beautiful thing.
Yeah. He's got lipstick marks that he's preserving. He's got fists of pure emotion.
He shattered someone's head.
Yeah, this has already started up. Oh, this is fucked already.
But at least in the last line, he realizes he's got to leave. Like, this is a crime scene. I've got to get the fuck out of here now. I need to leave this all behind.
It is time to leave.
Now.
I'm getting 20 to life. I'm going to put all this behind.
This bird's got to fly. Yeah.
He's on the
And then he's just like, take that. And then he just runs away.
That's a good band name, actually.
Yeah. I'm going to call my friend. Robbie Williams.
Yeah. And others.
And others who will not be remembered.
Okay, the chorus. Okay, we're going to get into this denial defense here. Whatever I said, whatever I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good. Want you back, want you back, want you back for good. Whenever I'm wrong, just tell me the song and I'll sing it. You'll be right and understood. Want you back, want you back, want you back for good. I want you back for good. Is this the regret of a murderer?
Why does this sound like church on a Sunday when the priest is like, whatever I said, whatever I did, I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good. And the rest of the church is like, want you back, want you back, want you back for good. Whenever I'm wrong, just tell me the song and I'll sing it. You'll be right and understood.
Understood.
I want you back for good.
I always thought the line was kind of weird where he's like, whenever I'm wrong, tell me the song and I'll sing it. Like, that's not how it works when you're wrong.
Look, I know you're looking for a distraction here, but you can't expect her to be the one to bring up, like, the what you did wrong in song form. It's like, look, okay, I'm finding it hard to understand what I did. What's the nearest song that describes what I did? Murder on the Dance Floor? I'll sing it. No worries. It sounds like he's got like the dead body curled up in his arms. He's like in the kitchen and it's like, whatever I said, whatever I did, I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good.
He's like shaking up.
She's never coming back, man.
I just want you back for good.
Wake up! Please wake up! You're just sleepy, right? You're sleeping. I didn't mean it.
This isn't happening. This is all a dream.
Tell mom.
Just tell me the song and I'll sing it. I'll sing it.
You'll be right and understood.
Yeah, that's another weird dead. One.
What song, you'll be what song right do you reckon that, what song's being told to be sung, though?
Yeah, well, that's what I was thinking, like...
Oh, my darling.
Cher Lloyd.
You'd be getting him to sing fuck songs if that was the deal. Like, if he'd just done something that, like, he was in the wrong and the deal now is, like, you just have to tell him to sing a song. He's like, you know what? You're a bloody bitch. And she's like, huh? He goes, oh, fuck, that was all right. I was wrong there. All right, what'll it be? What am I going to sing? Like, oh, man, what's really fucked? I'll tell you what's really fucked. What's the song we just did that we gave it all tens?
Oh, Last Friday Night.
Yeah, that one. Do some Katy Perry.
Yeah.
It's like, no!
No!
The only song that came to my head where there's a line where it's like something about being wrong, it's like, oh my gosh, I was wrong. It was Earth all along.
I hate every chimp I see, from chimpanzee to chimpanzee. You'll never make a monkey out of me. Oh my God, I was wrong. It was Earth all along. You finally made a monkey. Yes, you finally made a monkey. Yes, you finally made a monkey out of me.
I love you, Dr. Zaius.
Bah!
And she just magically comes back to life and she's like, all right, forgiven.
Can I want you back anymore? Of course you can. Well, I couldn't before.
All right, the second verse.
What's wrong with you? What's wrong with me? I think you're lazy. Want a second opinion?
You're all so crazy.
Yeah.
Dr. Zayas. So good. All right, verse two. Unaware, but underlined. I figured out this story. No, no. It wasn't good. No, no. But in the corner of my mind, I celebrated glory. But that was not to be. In the twist of separation, you excelled at being free. Can't you find a little room inside for me?
This got real, like, this got real heady, didn't it?
It certainly did.
Heady?
Yeah.
Complicated.
Oh, okay.
Lots of big words and...
It's very hard to actually figure out what he's getting at with this.
I mean, look, if we're going with the idea that he's killed someone.
Yeah.
If we put it in that context and we think, in the twist of separation, you excelled at being free. So that I interpret that as like, there was a moment where she was able to separate from him and like she was free.
She sort of was running around the house, happy. But couldn't.
Yeah, she
but
was,
couldn't,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. She's like, fuck, like, she's good
she's
at this.
She's excelled at that. Yeah, she's really good at that.
She really wants to get out of this house, doesn't she?
Yeah.
I celebrated glory? What a bizarre line.
What is that? Yeah, that's weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
I feel like that's just there because...
It's not.
Oh, I don't know why it's there.
It's not the right
with
anything.
That's a filler line.
Well, even no. Like, okay, so let's read the first two...
Yeah.
First two lines, just on their own. Unaware but underlined, I figured out this story. It wasn't good.
Yeah, what's he at?
You don't even have to make fun of it. It's like, it's weird on its own.
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't good.
It wasn't good.
That's very confusing when you read all of that. And then to get to the end of it and he's like begging for there to be a little room inside for him.
That's weird. Can't you find a little room inside your body for me? It's like, no,
it's kind of got a Silence of the Lambs sort of thing going on. Like he's going to wear a skin like a coat.
Puts the lotion on his skin.
Yeah.
Or else it wants you back again.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Fucking hell.
Pretty much. All right. They smash out another chorus. Get to the bridge. The bridge is, and we'll be together. This time is forever. We'll be fighting, and forever we will be. So complete in our love, we will never be uncovered again.
Yep, that settles it.
Yep, he's wrapped it up with a nice little bow.
Wrapped it
we'll
up with
together,
a nice
this
coffin.
Time forever, we'll be fighting, we will never... He's like, you're going to go to Hogwarts, you're going to do spells and shit, and you're going to be pleased about it.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, mate, you fucking call the shots, do you?
Look,
we will never be uncovered again because we will be covered in dirt. Because we will be in the ground. Yeah.
Unmarked grave. Unmarked.
Like a man grave.
Yeah. Only I know where you are and I'm not digging you up again.
So dark.
Remember that podcast we were going to do where we give it situation and then talk about the best way to murder someone?
It'd be the first true crime... encouragement podcast.
Encouragement, yeah.
Instead of like, Gav was all in on that. Like, he messaged me. He's like, I'm in. I'm like, it was a joke.
He's like, no, I'm in on doing some crime.
Yeah, yeah. I'd like to be encouraged.
Has not stopped encouraging.
Encourage me
since.
Please.
Yeah.
He's like, I can use my real life experiences to give you guys opinions on what you should do. And I'll be like, what?
Okay.
Yeah, he's like, there's this fucker that lives down the road from me and I really want to kill him and like, do you dare me to?
He needs some
just
like,
just no. Tell me to do it.
Do you guys,
like,
do you guys
just
dare
tell
me
to
do it?
Do it and I'll do it.
I don't
I'll
want
sing
you, to
you
do
a
it.
Song.
No, just say do it and I'll do it. Like, I don't want you to. No, but like, please.
Yeah.
It's like that Facebook thing. It's like, one like and I start drinking and then you like your own thing and you're like, done.
You're the king of Facebook, Bev. I don't know, mate. I don't know about
That's
that.
How you do it.
Okay.
You know those things that on Facebook and it used to be like for a comment or something, like a like for an opinion on you or something, or
oh yeah.
I did one of them once. I was like for a comment, and then I liked my own status, and I just wrote prick.
It was the only one on there.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Just don't you want to know what I think of you?
Do you want to know what I think of me?
I could just listen to this podcast. I'll tell people whether they want to know about it or not.
Lord knows he doesn't.
Sav's never heard it before. For all he knows, it doesn't even come out. Like this is a prank. This is us.
I wouldn't have a fucking clue.
This is us pranking him that we make him come on every Tuesday and do this.
It's a real elaborate intervention.
Yeah.
He's like, Tuesday's the night that I normally shoot heroin into my toes. And we're like, don't do that anymore, but do a podcast with us instead. He's like, okay.
Well, I guess I'll be too sleepy after that to do the heroin.
And now we just feel obligated to continue the podcast because it's just like...
To keep Zab
alive. You guys, I just do the heroin afterwards anyway, so...
Who's the real winner here?
Yeah.
So they smash out another chorus and the outro is, I guess now it's time that you came back for good.
Do you guys ever like, we're all talking the podcast stuff and you think something in your head and you're like, no, it's not really funny, but like something in me wants to say it. I'm going to say
it. No, I don't think of that. I normally have already said it, but then go, ooh.
All I've been thinking about.
What's that word? What's the think?
Yeah.
What is that? What is that?
Right now I'm not doing that. All I can think about this whole song, I've been like, I want you back for good instead of evil.
Instead of evil.
You know, like,
I want you back for good.
Yeah. Like I'll use
can you
like
stop
you
being the
good.
Joker and just be like
now that you've got
normal.
These powers, use them
you know,
for
you
good.
You know, like
not
sometimes
evil.
Superman goes a bit evil in the comics because they have nothing else to do with him. And then Lois Lane's like, this time I want you back for good.
Oh, right. Yeah, okay.
That's
yeah.
Remember there was that, I read a comic once where he went so bad that he lasered a paraplegic person. Lasered him in half.
He knocked him
name?
Off. In,
Christopher
he knocked,
Reeve.
Yeah. He got so bad that he lasered a horse's fucking hoof and it reared up and an old mate came flying off the back of it and landed straight on his spine.
Oh, it's so ironic that, isn't it? I mean, like, it's not that ironic, I guess, but it's
it
like,
is.
If,
an
it's
indestructible,
just ironic
an indestructible character where the person playing it was very, very destructible.
Very destructible. Yeah, it's like if the horse had kicked Superman off, nothing would have happened at all. He would have just flown away.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Could have like become suspended in the air and went, oh, if I wasn't a man who could fly, I would have fallen onto my back.
Yeah, been in a wheelchair
but I can
for
fly.
Life.
But I can fly.
Yeah. And looked weird in every photo till the day I died.
Let's move on before we all say something we regret.
About Christopher Reeve.
What?
I don't think
you're
there's
just
enough.
Let me and Chib say
I don't
stuff
think there's
regret.
Enough Reeve jokes out there, if you ask me.
He doesn't deserve it.
Who? He might have been a fuckwit. I don't know.
He might have. We better insult him because he might have been a fuckwit.
It's a given, really, isn't it?
That's a really good one.
Quit until proven
to live your life.
Back for good.
Yeah.
You're just down the shop. Someone's like, g'day, mate. Just the carton of eggs. Thanks. You like eggs, do you? He's like, yep. You're like, you're a fucking cunt.
I'll bet you do.
He's like, excuse me. And you're like, look, you might be a fuckwit. You might be a fuckwit. I'm just
that,
making
that might have been justified.
It's a sliding scale.
I'm just covering all bases here.
He's like, well, you're right, but it's a principle.
Well, I've told you like how I determine like where I start with anyone I meet, a new person I meet, like at any point, is that, you know, like most people start at like an even ground and then it goes either up or down depending on their personality, how much you get along with them, that sort of thing. You either dislike them or you like them, but you don't make a judgment about them until you've met them. I don't believe in that at all. I believe in the
hating people.
I start at a deep hatred. Like, I fucking hate you. And then you earn it.
Does that mean the three of us have earned it?
You're getting there.
Yeah, cool.
Is there anyone
that's fine.
Keep rolling.
What are they actually earning? Like Your friendship?
No,
your
no. That's, I don't have any rich friends.
$17 an hour after tax.
Yeah, yeah. Just like,
which is pretty good.
Mostly like how much I can tolerate someone's company.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
Mm. Is there anyone that's made it so far?
My brother.
Okay. Did it? Was he put through the same?
Yeah,
process?
Yeah. I've known him since I was born.
What about your wife?
So yeah. She's getting there, but no, that goes
she
up and down.
There and then she left.
It goes up and down, up and down.
What about that thing when you walk into the bathroom?
He's got like a little chart.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, you've
you know, like the those charts you see on the side of the road about like how dangerous it is for fire, like at the moment.
Oh yeah.
It's sort of like that, you know. It's like today we're at fucking catastrophic. Yeah, like just fuck off. Yeah.
What about that thing that stares at you in the mirror? Do you like that
thing? No, that's never got anywhere. Nah, it's a deep, cool, deep hatred there. Yeah.
Ah, cool. Yeah. Nice.
And
nice.
And there's a mirror right next to my bed, so it's the first thing I see in the morning is this cunt.
Mm. Yeah, so Robbie Williams, guys.
No, fuck Robbie Williams. This song is solely written by Gary Barlow.
There's no Robbie Williams in there, is there? I tried to listen out for his distinctive
He's only credited as a backup vocalist.
Yeah.
This is
probably why it's so good.
So yeah, take that. You do have the whole band, but this song in particular is only written by Gary Barlow. Gary has written 14 number one singles, 10 with Take That, 3 solo, and Run 1 with Robbie Williams, and 24 top 10 hits. It's a fucking hit machine. Oh, Gary.
Couple of hits here and there.
Hey?
Couple of hits.
Imagine that. 24 top 10 hits and 10 fucking number one singles out of the songs you've written. Probably hasn't written that many. Mm. They're all hits.
That's fucking awesome.
He claims
it's not 11,
to have written
so I don't
this
really
song.
Care.
Yeah. He claims to have written this song in 15 minutes. It's one of those ones.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. He knocked it out.
We had this discussion before where people talk about songs that they've written in like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
It's like, that's pretty much every song. Like,
yeah.
You write it and then it's done. And then you go into the studio and you're like, oh, we'll just tweak it here and there. It's like every fucking song, you don't spend fucking 2 months on a song. Sorry.
No.
You fucking don't.
No. And if you do, it's probably not going to be very good.
They're usually the shittiest ones.
Yeah.
The best songs are the ones that come out quick.
Yeah. You've overthought it. Yeah. So Gary Barlow stated on ITV, an audience with Take That live broadcast on the 2nd of December 2006, that there were 89 versions recorded by other artists of this song.
Couldn't name one.
How's that?
Covers or?
89 like covers of
89
this song.
Like actually recorded and released versions of this song by other artists.
I've never ever heard one.
Nah.
Other than
never heard one. No.
That's like, you know, like, there's a real common like trivia thing where they say like Yesterday by the Beatles is the most covered song of all time. I've never heard a cover of Yesterday. I could not name one.
Mustang Sally would be the most.
Actually, I take that back. I take that back. The one cover of Yesterday I've ever heard is Daffy Duck's version of Bugs Bunny and Friends.
Oh, the only one, the only other one I've heard is from the Mr. Bean movie where they're drunk walking home in the street.
Have you seen the movie Yesterday?
Suddenly.
Yeah.
I haven't seen it, but I want to. I've heard it's
fucking...
I've heard it's all right.
It's okay.
It's all right.
It's not great. It's not shit.
Does he play Yesterday in that?
Yeah, I think he does.
Okay. Well, two then, fuckwit.
Yeah, that's true.
Wait, remember when Ryan said he hadn't heard a single one?
Oh, I don't fucking remember.
Found out that he heard two?
Yeah. What about that song by Kermit
Lies!
Now that we're talking about Muppets again... That song by Kermit the Frog where he goes, why are there so many songs about rainbows? What? Over the Rainbow and the fucking song you're singing right now. Name one other rainbow song. There's none.
Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Yeah, that one that fucking Kermit sung.
Yeah, there's two. That's it.
Why are there so many
songs
can
about
do Kermit?
Kermit.
Kermit the Frog.
No, of course you can, though. Yeah.
Can anyone else?
Hey, Bert.
There you go.
Hey, Bert.
Wait, who am I? I'm Kermit.
Hey,
I'm
coming.
Whatever.
So Take That formed in 1990. They broke up in 1996. And in that time, they had 28 top 40 singles.
Fuck. I don't know any of them.
Like, that's a lot.
That's a fair bit.
Yeah. Yeah. They're bigger than the Beatles.
Yeah. Oh, take that, Beatles.
Robbie Williams, probably the most famous member of Take That. He left the band.
He's had a few hits too.
He's fucking done all right for himself. He left the band in the middle of their world tour in 1995. The rest of the band completed the tour and then broke up. That was it. Wow. So, but he fucked off. He was like, I'm out.
He's like, I'm much bigger than this.
Yeah. So four of their albums are listed in the best-selling albums of the millennium, with three of them among the 60 best-selling albums in UK chart history.
Fuck. Really goes to show that, like...
They were big, though.
This song was huge. The 90s,
like,
Take That
massive.
Were huge.
That's the thing. Like, I can tell you that Take That is a band, and Take That has Robbie Williams in it, and this is one of their songs. That's about it. That's all I know about them. But they are one of the most popular bands on the planet.
Yeah, crazy. Hey,
I'm looking at their like.
And while you're getting fucking sucked into your Metallicas and your fucking Foo Fighters and shit, you're fucking forgetting the talent, mate.
Gary, the fucking talent, fucking Barlow.
Yeah, I'm gonna check out some Take That. Hey, I feel like I'm missing out on some gems.
Yeah, I reckon there'd be heaps of stuff in there that you go, oh, I know that one.
Yeah,
oh, I know that one.
I live for that.
I just looked at their. Yeah. Their top five on Spotify, and just by their name, I don't know any.
Can I tell you what I listened to for the very first time today, and it was amazing, and I kind of was sat there listening to it going, I can't believe that I am 35 years old, and I'm experiencing this for the first time, and it's, like, it's fucking sick. You know what I listened to?
Was it Santeria by Sublime?
No, I've heard that before. I'd never heard this before. I listened to Dark Side of the Moon by Pink Floyd.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
All right.
It's a good one.
Did you like it?
It was so good.
It's good.
It's not bad.
Not their best, but it is a good one.
Well, I'm going to listen to more, but I really liked it.
It's definitely their best.
See, yeah.
There'll be some obscure thing they released in 1994, like Paul McCartney and Bevo will be like, that's the fucking peak.
Yeah. Nah, the worst one was The Wall, mate. The Wall is the shittest album.
I really enjoy The Wall, but that's not my favorite. Oh, my favorite's Wish You Were Here, the Shine On Crazy Diamond.
Yeah, I don't know about any. I don't know anything about Pink Floyd, but I listened to that today and
you don't like long songs though,
you've
so you
told me
you won't like this.
Yeah, okay.
I swear, Chibs, you've told me how shit Pink Floyd is before.
Yeah, I've never listened to them. See, this is what I'm saying. I start at Deep Hatred. I start at Deep Hatred.
Mate, this is what I'm telling you. I start at Deep Hatred.
I start at Deep Purple.
I'm trying to explain it.
Yeah. Start at Deep Purple, end up Pink Floyd.
Yeah, I've never listened to Deep Purple either, but they're fucking shit. Yeah.
Oh, don't listen to them. You're not really missing much, to be honest.
Of that one.
Yeah. Okay, so Mark Owen joined Take That. He's one of the members of Take That. After his trials with Manchester United and Rochdale FC, didn't come to anything. So, could have been a fucking professional football player. Instead, went and joined Take That.
How good is people's names where it sounds like one word if you say it the right way?
Mark Owen.
Mark Owen?
Yeah.
Well, everyone's name does that if you say it right.
And I do like this one.
Ryan Beveridge.
This one's got very little to do with Take That, but I enjoyed reading it and wanted to mention it. Robbie Williams. You know who his next door neighbour is?
Robin Williams?
No.
Willie
he's,
Robbins.
He's dead. Huh?
Willie Robbins.
No, it's Jimmy Page.
Oh,
yeah,
really
yeah.
Cool. Next
to neighbor.
Like,
yes.
Turn that fucking guitar down.
Yeah, well.
Well, hang on. They're neighbors, but they both live on fucking 50-acre properties, so they're not really.
Yeah. That's in a building. Like, they're in one building.
An apartment.
Yeah, like Jimmy Page owns the country next to the country that Robbie Williams owns.
In a long-running planning battle between the two musicians, Page delayed Williams' plans for an underground swimming pool in 2018, stating that construction work would damage the tower house, which has been Page's home since 1972. So by digging out all the foundations underneath Robbie's house, he thought it might fuck his house next door, which might have. And basically, as like retribution, Robbie Williams just sets giant stereo speakers up and plays like Take That songs and his so- like anything from his, just blasts it at Jimmy Page's house.
That can't be real. That doesn't
to this
happen.
Day. He does it for shits and giggles.
What the fuck?
It's one of the great wars of our time.
Yeah. How's that?
And he's always just saying, Take That, Jimmy Page.
Yeah.
What's that show? It's like Neighbors. Wars or something. Bad Neighbors, yeah.
Neighbors.
Oh, that's a movie, isn't it? That's Neighbors. That's what I'm thinking
of. Yeah. Polly Valance. Tits.
That show about people that live next door to each other.
Carl Kennedy.
Yeah. Carl Kennedy, Toadfish, Tadpole.
Tadpole. Susan Kennedy.
Whoever Carl got pregnant this week.
Various mollusks.
production. So this is also produced by Gary Barlow.
Really?
Yes.
Good on
him. He did get help from one Chris Porter, apparently. More on the engineering side. But he's produced and engineered for Elton John and George Michael, so he knew what he was doing. But so Gary wrote it and produced it. Gazza, hey? That shows that you're holding some fucking power in the industry if they're letting you be the dude that's like, I will also produce it. It's like the movie star that wants to direct their movie, you know? And it's like no. It's like, well.
They suck.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anything with Ben Stiller in it.
You act good. You act good. That's true. But you know what you don't do good? Yeah. Everything else.
Yeah.
This is the opposite of no Gary, no, isn't it? This is yes, Gary, yes. Well done.
Yeah. Fuck, Gary's nailed it, I think.
Nice one, Gary.
The whole, like, what sounds like a Yamaha, like, E243 piano sound and the drum beat from like the demo button. It's
now,
how
long it's been since you've worked in music retail, Chibs? They have a 273 now?
Nah. Yeah. That's not that model. I didn't use that model though.
That model's shit.
Yeah. It sounds so mid-90s. Like it just, I think it ages it. But at the same time, it's like just right. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like it's,
I
would hate to hear this with like a real, like, big sounding drum kit on it and like an actual fucking grand piano playing that.
How's the vocals?
I just realized that it doesn't have real drums. It's just got electric drums.
Yeah. Like... yeah, yeah. It's like what you hit the rhythm section on your keyboard. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what it is. Gary producing it was just him and his keyboard. Yeah.
Yeah, and he's just done it with
auto,
his two
like
fingers.
Auto chords.
Two
yeah, he's like Ross when he like shows it on his fucking keyboard
his
skills. He's like, wait
his
for
sound.
Electrifying.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was going to say, the vocals are the perfect.
My sound.
Like, if you did this at a full belt, it'd sound shit. If you did this at a whisper, it'd sound shit. It's just that perfect, like, just the falsettos in the right places. The fact that you guys were singing it before we started the episode, just like...
the vocal sound, how they actually sit, they sound amazing. Like the way it's recorded, even the backup vocals are done to fucking perfection.
Yeah.
Perfection. Mm. And Gary Barlow's got the voice of a fucking angel.
Yeah, they sound like airy synths.
Yeah.
Like,
it does. Yeah. Yeah.
That's what it sounds
like. Want you back?
Yeah.
Want you back for good.
John Williamson.
I want you back. I've got a fist of pure emotion. Got your lipstick mark still on your coffee cup. Gotta leave it all behind. Gotta leave it all behind. Whatever I said, whatever I did, I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good.
Got a lipstick mark on your midi of 2 years old.
Just tell me the song. Tell me the song and I'll sing it. You'll be right. You'll be right and understood. I want you back for good. I want you back.
All right. The video, Bevo.
Love that song.
You love that song. that new one from Take That. What's the video?
Feel Good, I-98.
Feel Good, that's right.
Feel Good. Bevo.
Yeah.
Video, mate.
Yeah.
Did you watch it? Southern.
I did.
Oh, cool.
Dan Southern, hit it.
Okay, mate, no problem. Just looking for my ocarina. Oh, I don't have one.
Some fuckwit won't lend it to me.
Because I'm not a fucking idiot.
I got you here. It's all right. Except
don't.
Yeah, why don't you just hit your ocarina?
Don't.
Check out, it makes a face.
Don't.
It looks like a face.
Oi. Oi, Ryan. Hey, don't.
I can't because you need two hands for it. And one of
don't,
my hands
dude.
Is busy.
Right. Good. Put it away. Right, well, put it away. Go. Back here in the drawer. Bye-bye.
Click. Click.
Here's the video facts from A to Z, and they're coming at you straight from Ryan B. It's a terrible song, and I know you agree. It's the music video summary
with Bevo.
All right. This one's really short because the other one's really long. Stay tuned next week for that one. Take That. A handful of dickheads do some stupid shit in the rain.
Yeah, there's some pretty sick cars in it, though.
Yeah.
What did you think of the cars?
Yeah, but they're all just going to get, they're all going to fucking get rusty, aren't they?
Or how much you reckon having the...
You don't take those cars out in the fucking
rain.
How
much do you think having to cut the rust out of that and replace some panels would be?
Oh, mate, on a fucking,
it's like a
58 fucking Chevy. Yeah, yeah mate. Is it a 58?
Yeah, I think there's a 58 in there and a 50.
Yeah, the Impala, yeah.
And a 52 or something, like something yeah. real old.
Couple of, yeah, probably, you know, your sills and your quarter panels is where you're going to get most of the damage, right? And that's quite structural, so they've got to be done in order to pass roadworthy.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're looking at a fucking 3 or 4 week wait to get the off cuts in there, mate.
That's if I order them today.
Tack weld them in. Yeah, you got to get them ordered today, actually, because it's Friday afternoon. I don't know.
Don't you think it's crazy?
I started losing it.
That for like this, the story of like, well, look, maybe it's about murder, maybe it's not. But let's say, just for shits and giggles, mm-hmm. it's not. Could they not have like got a woman in this video at all and showed some sort of love story playing out?
Yeah, but the thing is, this song, the target audience doesn't need to see a woman.
Oh, it's for women.
It's for women, yeah.
Because they're all beautiful men. Okay.
Can we talk about that Robbie Williams has not had a successful solo career at this point yet, but he's looking smug as fuck for
He knows he's
who,
going to.
Yeah.
For someone who has no role in this song except for a backing vocal.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's already signed.
He's already thinking about the size of woofer that he's going to use for his speakers to piss off Jimmy Page.
Yeah.
he's going to go the 8s or the 10s. Fuck,
he's going to entertain you in his head.
Yeah, this, like, what, this came out in 95, I think. So he was look, it's most likely, not even impossible, that he already knew exactly what he had lined up.
Yeah, because it wasn't far off this point.
That's right.
Him being
so he's like
big.
His managers just said, Robbie, we're not ready to hit the activate button yet. So you just keep playing.
He's like, I'm going to buy me a fur coat.
Yeah,
and now I'm going to put a pool underground next to Jimmy Page's house.
So just play. Keep like, just none gonna, of that play yet. Along. Play along
I'm
with the
put
boys.
Pool underground and like. I'll wear a fur coat. Yeah, we got that.
Why am I sounding underground as well? Sharon, why do I sound like Ozzy Osbourne?
Can you find out where Jimmy Page lives? Yes, we'll do that. Just go back to the video. You're attracting too much attention.
Yeah, yeah. Stop talking about it. They can hear you. They're
his
right
dance
there.
His dance moves suggest that he's just found out the address of Jimmy Page and he's like heaps smug about it. He's like, yeah, I'm going to dance because now I know where to go.
He does a few knee drops in the rain and shit. Yeah.
They all do.
Yeah.
Did you guys read about what happened to all these guys after the filming of this film?
They got syphilis or something, didn't they?
Hypothermia.
What?
They got AIDS.
Turns out you can get it from the rain.
Turns out filming a music video where it's raining at a nuclear power plant is not a good idea.
Oh, man. Where is it? Robbie Williams just pulled out a dance move. I think it's like the 3-minute mark. he's like doing exactly what he does in Rock DJ, except in this film clip, he's got a fur coat. Yeah. In Rock DJ, he's doing it with his skin.
I was
going to
say, but this it's like one, the he's exact wearing same his thing. Skin.
He's got one trick.
Yeah.
yeah. nice.
I have a YouTube
on your
comment.
Robbie.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. What is it?
It is. This is for Carlos Montano Serrano, 2 days ago. There is something wrong with the lyrics. It is for sussies.
yeah, it is, isn't it?
I got one from Sarah Tanner, and she says from a week ago, Valentine's Day 2021, listening to this song in my bed.
yeah, good
That's
times.
what are
she
you doing? Wants someone back for
yeah,
good.
Yeah, yeah.
she really wants someone back for good.
She wants someone good for back.
Oh, all right.
Fuck it. Another, Ryan, another honestly, mate.
Okay. Cheating ain't eating.
What?
Cheating ain't eating.
No.
No, eating ain't
no.
cheating.
No, certainly is not.
Cheating ain't eating.
I don't know if he's saying that seriously or not.
all right. Some
set list.
Some like, did they play a show?
They played a show as recently as September 8th, 2019.
Oh, but that's not... That's
here we
not,
go. Here we go.
That's only three of them.
Yeah, sorry. I got a comment. Sorry.
Yeah.
So this is from May.
Hurry up,
Ellen
Daniel. We've already moved
Ellen
on
Barron.
To the next segment.
It's pronounced meme.
May. And this is 2 weeks ago, and this is edited. Okay? So just keep all that in mind. Okay. Wow. Thanks, Fi, this song. Ill love so much to my idol Gary Barlow. Super looks unequaled cute.
Okay. Just like, wait, what? I fucked that. Edit.
yeah, that's been edited. Oh, thanks so much to my idol Gary Barlow.
I'm not coming across right.
yeah.
Super looks unequaled cute.
Yeah.
Unequal.
Love that cute.
Love that cue.
Okay, well, what's, yeah, set list. When are we going from, Bevo?
Well, I've decided, at first I was going with, like, when the song came out, but I figured...
But you want to do it.
If we go the latest set list, we get all the hits.
Okay, so it's, all right.
You know.
Okay. Yeah. Hey, you're making the rules up, mate.
Yeah.
Do what you want.
You seem to be changing them every week, by the way.
Just making them up,
yeah.
It's hard to keep up.
8th of September, 2019, the Europa Point Sports Complex in Gibraltar. This is the Greatest Hits Live Tour, so we've got a lot of hits to get through. 20, in fact, including a Barry Manilow cover. So maybe
Rock DJ, let me entertain you.
Oh, I bet that's what happens,
Better
eh?
Man.
Yeah,
they
do it to Angels.
It's
like
been.
A yeah. bunch of Robbie Williams.
Well, yeah. I have a suspicion Robbie Williams isn't in this particular lineup.
No, I think they've continued on as a three-piece.
You know why? Because he's a better man.
Yeah.
He's a man for all seasons.
So there's 20 songs.
20 songs. Where, Chibs, would you play Back for Good?
Last.
Okay. Zev?
Second last.
Second last? Seven?
That's my thing.
hey, no, yep. You fucked that, mate.
Fucking, you fucking... Mm. Oh mate, no. Well, all right. Well,
oh mate, I'm fucking.
I'll
kill you.
I was actually dead set going second last. I'm gonna do that because I reckon that Barry Manilow covers last.
Take that play back for good. 12th
of
20 songs.
Fuck,
yeah,
that's lame. You can leave, I guess.
Well,
must be before intermission.
We're gonna find out after this if any of these songs are like bangers. But
yeah,
they close the set with Never Forget.
I forgot that one.
What happened here tonight?
yeah. The elephant song.
yeah, all right. 12th, good on him. All right, the song topped the UK singles chart whilst also charting at number one in 31 countries around the world.
Holy dooly.
Including Australia, Canada, Denmark, Germany, Ireland, Norway and Spain.
Iceland.
Yes, I'd assume so. It also charted at number 7 in the United States, their only hit in that country. At the 1996 Brit Awards, it won the Brit Award for British Single of the Year. In 2003, Q Magazine ranked the song at number 910 on its list of 1,001 best songs ever.
that make you want to die?
Yeah. And in and in a UK poll in 2012, it was voted number 11 on the ITV special, the nation's favourite number one single.
Do you reckon one day there'll be lists come out where people are like describing a band's accolades and they'll be like, you know, it was number one in Ireland and number 58 on greatest songs of all time, and it actually ranked 28 on 1001 songs that make you want to die's podcast list.
Yes, I do like, believe
our
that.
List just makes it out there somehow into the world. And
just before it's out there.
Genuine list. Well, I suppose it is a genuine list.
Before they had that horse accident.
And I like this one. I like this one for some legacy. See if you can guess who this quote is from. If it touches people, it's a good song. You know, people go on about take that, but Back for Good said something to me, and if it touches me,
Michael Jackson. Nah.
Touching you, sweet Caroline.
The diamond.
No, it's that's a quote from Noel Gallagher.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, Noel. Who's ruthless with everyone. He's just
No.
Hey, mate. Fucking good song.
I reckon he just gets off on like surprising people with opinions like that.
And the fact that he hates Robbie Williams so much, like, yeah, it's great. All right, some net worths here. I'm not going to do all of them, but let's say, so Howard Donald, Mark Owen, and Jason Orange, they're all got the same net worth. What do you think their net worth is, the three of them? Southern.
$20 million.
Bevo?
10.
Sav?
5.
They're all worth $40 million.
Wow.
Wow. So these are the no-namers. Okay?
Mm.
Not bad. 40 mil.
Take that. Gary, check to Gary, the bank.
Yeah. Gary Barlow's net worth.
Barry Garlow.
Barry Mellow.
Gary Barlow. Gary Barlow's net worth. Southern?
Oh. Fuck, he must be worth a lot. 110.
Bevo?
150.
Sav?
Trick question. 4.
He's worth $105 million.
Fuck, that's pretty close.
Pretty fucking close. That's pretty good. $105 million. Robbie Williams' net worth.
Now, I think I remember hearing something about him years ago where like he signed this record-breaking deal, and I'm pretty sure it was like $800 million or something like that at the time.
He's had a lot of drug problems.
Yeah, you can afford.
He was pretty good in Mrs. Doubtfire.
He's like,
I have drug problems and I earn fucking nothing, mate.
$40 million a year to drugs. I've still got a lot of millions.
Okay. So what do you think he's worth then? In 2021?
Now. I don't know. 200 million.
Bevo?
$400 million.
Sav?
Well, he gets invited to royal weddings, so I'm saying $800 million.
It's worth $300 million.
Ah.
Nah.
Is that D-Rex?
That's a lot.
What did you say?
I don't even know what I said.
I think you said 200.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter, does it?
Do I, the difference. I don't win anything.
No,
do
you don't.
Do anything?
Nah.
Is that me? Did I win that? I don't, like, doesn't matter. But
you get $1 million every time you get it right. All right. Let's rate this shit.
Motherfuckers, this is it. It's time to rate this shit.
Okay, so what are we going to rate it out of here? I don't even know.
How many fists of...
Oh, yeah, okay. How many, fists of a pure emotion out of 10? 10 being... it's 10 fists of pure emotion.
You get hit by 10 fists of emotions and you die.
How many times are you going... How many times are you going to be fisted?
Yeah.
By the purest
the frog, 10 being those two angry guys in the balcony.
Yeah, that's it. Okay. What do you give this out of 10, Zav?
This song is the first song I can remember ever knowing, ever singing along to, ever being obsessed with, and it's fucking amazing. It's like, if I could give it...
It's a 10.
A 0.
You can give it a 0.
It's a 0.
Fair enough. Bevo? What?
I don't know. Like, I like the song. It's okay. It's fine. There's nothing wrong with it. But I don't like... I never put it on for fun, you know. Maybe as a little sing-along. So I'm going to say 3.5. Throw a little half in there.
Oh, hates it. Okay. Southern?
What the fuck, man? This song gives me chills. Yeah. I remember being a kid and my parents, this is a true story. My parents like got divorced and they may or may not have been divorced at this point.
Oh, way to make it dark, dude.
The divorce was coming.
I thought the murder was bad.
Yeah. Well, the divorce was on its way. And then I remember like one night mum put us to bed and it was like, stay in bed. And I'm like, why? What's happening? She's like, just stay in bed. And so I got up and peeked out the door. Dad had shown up and he was dancing with mum in the living room to this song and he was singing her this song. And he was going, "Want you back for good." I'm like, oh, mum and dad are going to get back together. This is awesome. So I associate this moment with that moment with the song. Fucking love this song. Such a zero. And then, what happened next may surprise you. I put it on just before the podcast and went like singing it to Naomi down the hall. You know what she did?
Split up.
She wants a divorce.
Stop being a fuckwit. No. Do the dishes, you dickhead.
So let me squeeze the boobs.
Oh, sick.
What happened to your parents, though? Yeah. Your parents.
She was in a towel. She just said, she pulled the towel.
Yeah, I don't care about that. I fucking give a shit. What happened with your parents?
Oh, well, they got divorced. They're very divorced. My mum's actually been divorced twice. So, but third time lucky. The guy she's with now, he's real.
There you go.
Get that song away from that man.
Yeah, that's right. I'd give it a zero.
A fucking oath.
This is one of my pride.
This would have been the first time I cried on this podcast if we all had the same fucking. This is a zero.
This is one of my favorite songs.
Don't worry, I don't want to cry.
It's one of my favorite songs. Yeah. I play it on guitar all the time. I play it like I just put it on when I'm taking the kids to school. And
it is the best song to sing in the shower.
Oh, I love it.
To sing in the shower.
So Kylie, who requested this, sends a message through. You should do Back for Good by Take That. And I just wrote back, I fucking love that song. She thought I was joking. So I saw her in real life and she's like, you're joking about that though, right? It makes me want to fucking throw up. And I'm like, if I could show you my Spotify stats on how often I play this, like, I'm not fucking joking. Ness comes over, I'm like, how many times do I play Back for Good by Taylor? She's like, you fucking always play it. Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Take that. There you go. So I said, okay, no, we'll do it. But don't expect anyone to hate it.
No, it's great.
Except Bevo.
She thought I was crazy. Like, you are a crazy person. Everyone hates that song.
This song is so good.
Like, I don't think they do. Yeah. I think that's an unreal song.
It's universally
loved. No one hates this song.
Okay, just to play devil's advocate for a second, though. Like, absolutely do not hate it, but I lump it in with all those other, like, boy bandy.
Thanks for listening to 2001
songs. No,
it's so far above that.
Get around with your mates and just, like... Whatever I said, whatever I did, oh, I didn't mean it. I just want your back for good.
I don't think he's saying I want your back for good.
No.
Oh, fuck. Start again.
Start again.
Yeah. No, you got like NSYNC, Backstreet Boys. Yeah, I'm sure they've all got like a song that if I was to go through, I'd be like, this is a fucking sick song. Yeah. Like, this is cool. But they've also got a bunch of songs that made me go like, oh, it's lame. But none of those boy bands have got anything on this song. Okay.
I respect
the second it comes on, you have to listen to the whole thing.
I respect your opinion.
Oh, yeah.
And I think it's just like all the other ones.
Well,
see you next week. Bye.
It is still the
ring a ding ding ding.
It still hits the absolute fucking rock bottom of our songs that make you want to die list. Good.
Well, I need to ask a question about zero. Is like, does zero contribute to the score?
No, the score now of this is 3.5 out of 40. Yeah.
Right. Whatever I said, ding. Whatever I did, minute.
I didn't.
I just want
ding, 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 ring for ding, 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 ding,
ring for ding,
bang, 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 ring for ding, ring for ding, bam, bam.
All right.
Before we go, everyone, if you're going to request a song, maybe you should send us a video of your own rant just to get your piece in, because it could end up like this. It could be like, yeah, they're going to fucking do my song, and then we might love it. So at least we could like feature your little rant.
Yeah, at least get your hatred in on it.
Send us a little Facebook voice message, and we'll chuck it in the podcast.
We'll chuck it on there.
Put it in there.
All right, get fucked, everyone.
All right. Whatever.
Bye.
Ring-a-ding, a ring-a-ding.